So this is Jorge Vega Rodriguez from Spain. Just tying in there. An old ubiquitous figure of 8 knots. Absolute staple for climbers. Probably the first thing you learn as a climber, the figure of 8 knots. The under 16s all have to tie in with it as well. Can't do it. They can't let someone else do it. You got it? Just tie it back on it, in on itself, put the tail away. So good to see a full team here from Spain. We've got three Spanish athletes. We haven't seen Spain much on the European or World Tour in recent years, so really great to see them. They put together a full team in Saspe a few weeks ago. So here we go. Jorge Vega Rodriguez. His 6 minutes has begun. With straight away this cheeky hard move. Right at the start of the route. Interesting using his hands there. Real feature of modern ice climbing. You wouldn't have seen that 10 years ago, perhaps not even 5 years ago. And now you're seeing climbers having to have the full array of skills from bouldering, lead climbing, to perform well. So, Vega Rodriguez is now on the route. Looking a little bit more comfortable than York was earlier. And of course, psychologically, that will be a big boost for him just to get on the route proper, to get past that first little awkward section. Get onto the scoreboard. And that begins, really, when he gets his first quick draw. The first quick draw is flipped for him, and then points come with every quick draw you're able to clip. What an awkward angle, that bit of stone. He just has a look around, he's not sure about it, maybe it takes a tool that way round. It's an undercling, floating undercling, not quite as secure. The stein, which is when the head of the axe is flush against the wall, has a lot of core stability. So far, so good for the 16-year-old. A little bit of blue sky behind him. Earlier in the under-16s, the sun came out. It was, one part of the route was bathed in lovely low winter sunlight. Not sure there was a lot of warmth in it though. -7 outside. So Vega Rodriguez looking pretty confident now as he steps out onto the overhanging section of the structure. In the figure of 4, trying to get past this little bit of a hanging fin. Figure 9. Now this roof in total is 16 meters long, and it's known locally as the Husky Hanky. Apparently means the kinky overhang. Okay, struggling here a little bit to surmount this obstacle, fighting. Stay on the route. A little bit out of sight on what exactly is going on. but teammates are giving him a lot of encouragement from below. It's under 2 minutes remaining, so he's got time on the clock, but whether there's much time left in those arms and legs as the lactic acid builds up. Seems a little bit more secure at least now as he gets quick draw number four. He's at least on the scoreboard. Quick draw number four gives him a score of 4 and 17. That's the hold that he's at. This is the 17th hold on the route. Only a minute remaining now. It's deeply overhanging. Hanging with one arm, matches with the right. Can he get over? He does. Now that's where the strength comes in. Really a strong lad. Did well just to be able to hang off one arm. Maintain his composure. Match with the right. Can he get that next quick draw? He does. On five. With half a minute remaining on the clock. He's still in the fight. Jorge Vega Rodriguez. Great view of the climb from this angle. You really get a sense for just how steep, how overhanging it is. Just how small some of these holds are. Matches right. Oh, he's off. Oh, he did well. Heroic save, but looks like the clock is up. Vega Rodriguez seems pretty happy. See the signs of a smile there on his face. He at least has set the marker now. 5.19. Lost a lot of valuable time at the first overhang. We worked out the sequence of moves required. Well, it would be interesting to see how the rest of the field follow, whether they too will come find that as challenging as he did. So well to hang in there, but he was out of time.